Are you looking to make more money each week? And how does making $40,000 a year sound when you're just delivering groceries? Over the past 6 weeks, I've consistently made $800 a week or more, and in the last 2 weeks, I've consistently made $1,000 just delivering groceries. Follow along with me in this video to see what I am doing to be on track to make $40,000 this year just delivering groceries. So I usually wake up whenever my body tells me. This is often around 7 to 9 a.m., but sometimes it can be as late as 10 or 11. If I wake up at 7 o'clock in the morning, then I will turn Walmart Spark on as soon as I get up and wait for the 7:15 order drop while I'm getting ready. This also applies when I wake up at 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock. I wait until the 8:15 or 9:15 or 10:15 order drop while I'm getting ready, so that way I don't miss the first offer that I'm showing that day on the app. Sometimes I make myself a lunch and put it in a little cooler bag and bring it with me, so that way I can just eat a lunch in my car, but often I'll just buy lunch while I'm out returning to Walmart from a delivery. The last order that I usually take in a day is at 4:15 p.m. because it gets dark around 4:30 here and I don't like driving at night. Sometimes I'll work until later, like when I was doing the $160 bonus for the 20 deliveries, which if you haven't checked out that, you can check it out in the upper right-hand corner now. I don't like working past 5 p.m. It is really hard to find house numbers here when it's late at night because there isn't much light and not many houses have house numbers here. This means that I either work between 7:30 to 4:30-ish, or I work 8:30 to 4:30-ish on a day that I work full schedule. Now, you might think that this is a lot of time to spend working on a gig app, but this is what I was doing before with Instacart. And the most that I made with Instacart in 1 week, working 9 o'clock till 5 o'clock, was $728. Not to mention, with Instacart, I was driving a lot more miles, and I had a less gas-efficient car at that time, so in reality, I was making less money than I am now. So with Instacart, I was working from 9 o'clock till 5 or 6 p.m. So I was actually working more hours, and I didn't even get close to the same amount of pay that I've been getting with delivering with Walmart Spark. So how many orders do I take a day? I try to do 9 orders a day if there's a bonus program that says, like, complete 9 orders today and get X amount of dollars bonus after completing the ninth trip. So if there is a bonus program for that day, I'll try to complete the bonus program. But if there's not a bonus program, then I'll usually do 6 or 7 orders in a day, depending on how much time I actually have before it gets dark. Some days I just do 1 or 2, maybe 3 orders just to make a quick $20 to $60. I usually do these on the day after I've worked a bunch, so that way that day is a tip payment day and a small amount of orders payment day. For example, if you work on a Monday and you get a bunch of tips on a Monday, then they'll become available and show up in your earning tab on Tuesday after 24 hours post delivery. So on Monday, say you make $200 in tips. On Tuesday, if you do absolutely nothing, then those tips will come in and you'll have a $200 income for Tuesday. So this is why I like to work only a couple of hours on the days I know I'm getting a lot of tips. If you do work every day, then you'll notice that the second day that you start working, for example, if you don't work on Sunday, then you work on Monday, and then you work on Tuesday, you'll notice that Tuesday will be a lot more earnings because you have Monday's tips combined with Tuesday's income, and Tuesday's tips will become available on Wednesday. There's the possibility to make way more money than what I'm making. Because I only work 7 to 9 hours a day, sometimes even less than that, there are people that will work all 15 hours that Walmart Spark is available in the day, and they're making way more money than I'm making. If the driver's lucky enough, then they can do more than one delivery per hour, and the base pay from Walmart Spark is $7 per delivery. So if somebody completes 15 trips in a day at just the base pay of Walmart Spark, then they will make $105 for that day without getting any tips. Also, the shop and deliver orders pay a minimum of $20.26 in my experience. So if you're lucky enough to get all of those in a day, then you'll easily make over $300 that day. And did you know that if you make $300 for 300 days of a year, then you have made $90,000 that year? Also, orders get little pay increases if you have to spend more time or do more effort to complete the order. These are automatically completed by the Walmart Spark system. Say, for example, that you get an order that says it's 2.3 miles, and you go to click the little navigation button and start the navigation to that customer's address, and you find out that the customer's address doesn't show up, so you have to hand type it in, and the customer is actually 9 miles away. You'll actually be compensated by the Walmart Spark system automatically after 24 to 48 hours because of this distance discrepancy. Also, there are a lot of people that tip in my experience, even if it's just $2 to $4 for the trip, so that'll add up over time. I do not accept any orders that are in-store pickup because these orders are batched together in a large number, say 5 to 15 different customers, and they don't allow customers to tip on these orders. These ones are really small, 1 to 10 items per customer, and they are non-grocery orders. These orders often pay about $1 a mile, but I have seen them go up to about $2 per mile with a $16 pay bonus. But if you don't accept it on the $16 pay bonus, then it will reset after the next hour and then go back down to the base price, and it'll go back up until it's at 16 again, unless somebody accepts it beforehand. But that's about all I have for this video. I hope that you guys have liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and consider hitting subscribe if you'd like to see more content like this. If you got something out of this video or you learned something new or you have any questions, please feel free to leave them down below in the comments and I'll try to answer your questions or comments. Are you guys interested in Walmart Spark or have you guys tried Walmart Spark and how is it in your experience? As always, thank you so much for watching and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.